And welcome back, everyone. Well, as you know, October is Breast Cancer Awareness Month, raising the awareness for women to do those regular self-checkups and just how, you know, deadly this cancer can be. We actually have a survivor of breast cancer joining us here this morning, MJ Jenkins. She is the author of Think No Pink that is set to be released here this month. First of all, MJ, what inspired you to write this book?
Well, first of all, I should say happy Breast Cancer Awareness Month. I am so grateful to be here live with you today, and I wrote my book, Think No Pink, because I was in the course of breast cancer, and I had the opportunity to record all of my mistakes, all of the things I did right, so I could be a best friend. I wish I had a best friend out there, and I want to be the BFF for other women who have breast cancer. And that's why I started my practice of being a breast cancer coach, to help women not make the mistakes that I made. And Think No Pink is really a frame of mind. You know, pink is related to cancer. Well, I think when you have cancer, it's best to eliminate pink from your thinking altogether. Eliminate cancer from your mind and your thoughts, words, and actions. Will either help you survive or they'll kill you.
And it has to be the biggest struggle you've ever faced, conquering it, beating it, a lot of women get diagnosed with breast cancer and they think automatic death sentence, but that's not the case.
Not the case at all. Matter of fact, you know, I'm a survivor. I'm a representative of the American Cancer Society. They say 1 in 8 women will get breast cancer in the course of their lifetime. Well, I'm one of those 8 women. In 2012, I was diagnosed with breast cancer, invasive ductal carcinoma, you know, the most common type that women get today. And with the help of Angelina Jolie's breast surgeon, I can happily say today I am cancer-free. I'm able to be in your beautiful studio with you beautiful people and be with my beautiful children.
We love you so much. You are just so full of life in more ways than one. I guess we could say, I wanted to ask you, so you went through this. Did you find a lump? How did you find out you had breast cancer? And what are some mistakes that women commonly make?
Well, actually, I was going through a typical mammogram checkup. And, you know, really, there's 3 mistakes I've narrowed it down to avoid when you're dealing with breast cancer. The first is not having early screenings. If I had not detected my cancer as early as I did, you know, I would be not here with you. I wouldn't be alive to spend the life with my children. No, today I would be dead. So the second mistake to avoid is eating cancer-causing foods. I was shocked at the number of foods cause cancer. Microwave popcorn, potato chips, and, you know, all those margaritas on Saturday night. So sugar feeds cancer. So you must avoid those foods. And the third mistake is not letting your midsection bulk up. You know, it's been proven that women who have fat around our waistlines are more likely to develop breast cancer than women who lead fit, healthy lifestyles.
And did anyone in your family have breast cancer, or did this just come as a surprise to you?
It was a huge shock to me because I'm one of those families that don't really talk about medical conditions. My grandmother had breast cancer. My great-aunt had breast cancer. And, you know, that's where I've come up with. In my book, I want to help women survive breast cancer. There's ways that you can help survive. I have a BFF formula, since it goes with my BFF guide to breast cancer in my book. The B stands for believe. The F stands for feed. You need to feed your body good food, but you need to feed your soul with good thoughts.
I love this. We have a special guest here.
Coco's with us
today.
She's my star and my angel. And it's great to have, I recommend with breast cancer, to have a puppy, someone who can keep you warm and keep you and help you heal through breast cancer. And the final F in my BFF formula is to, you know there's freedom. And once you have breast cancer, you really have a new lease on life. The ability to recreate yourself, redesign yourself, like I did, coming up with my new company to help others with breast cancer. And you actually have a way to heal others and heal yourself with breast cancer by your thoughts, words, and mind.
And MJ, I think it's so amazing that you took your story and now you have kind of crafted it into a book that other breast cancer patients can read. Read about your fight themselves.
Yes, I can help them save $250,000 not making the mistakes that I made. You know, not that's just in money, let alone the time, pain, and suffering. So I really want to talk during this month to help save women from making the mistakes in breast cancer.
And MJ, where can people get your book? And I understand that maybe there's a special gift for them for the month of October.
Yes, during the month of October, just email me at thinknopink.com.
Okay.
And I would be happy to give the book away during October.
Okay.
For launching
it. It is so nice to meet someone with such a fight, such a drive, and so appreciative of life.
Think No Pink.
Think No Pink. Again, MJ Jenkins here, joining us here on Mornings on Fox 11, breast cancer survivor, and Miss Coco here as well. We're so, so thankful to have you. And celebrities have